everybody, it's Tammy with TJ's Kids. I'm back today with my fifth and final day with my Growing in Unity Gals projects. And I want to thank everybody for watching all of my previous videos, and I want to thank everybody at Unity for allowing me to participate in this. I've had so much fun, and I saved my favorite project for last. I came up with this idea to do an altered project using some Unity stamps, and I'm using these two Unity stamps. Actually, I'm using these two Unity stamp sets, and we're going to use lots of stamps from these sets. I chose first to use the Piper Girl set, and we're going to use the Piper Girl herself and the one sentiment, which is "You make every new day beautiful." I love the Angie Girl stamps, so we're going to use that, and we're also going to use the Donna Downey Studios Empowering Words set, and we're going to use lots of sentiments from this set. Tons and tons of beautiful sentiments in this set, and we're going to use lots of them. We are going to create today a calendar slash planner, but it's not a planner like every other planner that everybody else is doing out there. I don't do your traditional planner. I do just a normal calendar. Matter of fact, this calendar came from the Dollar Tree. It's just your traditional. This is a next year's calendar. This is a 2017 calendar. I'm getting myself ready for next year. So I just went to the Dollar Tree and bought an El Cheapo dollar calendar. And it was actually kind of pretty. It was purple and pink and aqua stripe. But I'm going to decorate it to suit me. So let's jump in and get started. I did pre-cut and pre-start a few things just so it didn't drag out too long for us. Don't want to make you sit there forever and watch me. So let's push up our sleeves here and get started. I used for this Chamel's True Stories paper and some Amy Tan Rise and Shine paper. There's some older paper pads. And I started attaching some of them already. And I believe they measured 9.5. Let me do a quicker measurement for you. Yeah, it was 9.5, and I cut them by 6. I took a 12 by 12 sheet of paper, and I cut it 9.5, and cut it in half by 6. And then I took this piece of red striped and cut it 9.5 by, I believe, 4, and then I scored it in half here, and we're going to attach that to cover our spine piece here. And I found better than using ATG on this, because the ATG will lift a little. It's better to use a wet adhesive. You could use Scotch Quick Dry or another type. I myself love Scotch Quick Dry, but on this I was using this Martha Stewart. It's a glue pen. It's one of them two-way glue pens, and I found that it stuck really well for this. So I'm going to go ahead and use that, and we're going to put some, I'm going to slide that up out of our way for a minute. We're going to put some adhesive on this. As I said, I already scored this piece down the center to help me out a little bit. So it's a 9.5 by 4 inch piece of paper scored in the middle at 2 inches, and we're going to put some glue on here, and then we're going to bring our calendar back down here, and we're going to line that score up in the center there on our spine, and we can use our fingers to press down or bring that handy dandy bone folder back out and press down, and we want to try and get this as straight as possible. But the nice thing about working with wet adhesive instead of working with ATG on this is it gives us a little bit of time to move it around if it's not perfect, and then you can bend and crease along that spine again. You can use your bone folder or press with your fingers. Sorry about that phone going off there a little bit. And there we have our covered calendar. And that in itself would be okay. But I want to pretty it up and use my stamps. So you could ink around this more, you could stamp right on it, but I wanted to add some more color and texture to it. So what I wanted to do is, I have a bag full of goodies here, and in my bag full of goodies I have a bunch of stamped out sentiments from that Empowered Word, and I also have some enamel hearts and dots, and I have some washi tape here that I also would like to use. These are my sentiments, and most of these sentiments come from the Empowered Word, and we will put them on next. But first, I want to use some, this is some washi tape from Hobby Lobby. This is the Paper Studios brand. And I've not used this yet. I bought this, it came with a matching coffee cup washi tape, and I was going to use it, but the coffee cups were orientated the wrong direction. So I decided to use this one. So I'm going to use a little bit of this washi tape to bridge the gap between the red paper, the red stripes, and the coffee cup. So we're going to put a little bit of this on here. And I'm just going to kind of eyeball it and half it there. And just smooth that down. Oh, wrinkled a little bit there, so I'm going to pick that up and re-smooth it down. Reach over here and grab my scissors. You could choose to either fold it around the inside, like so, like I'm going to do. Or you could cut it off. And that just kind of neatens up your border a little bit there. So I'm going to flip it over and do the same thing on the back side with my washi. And you could do this however you chose to do it. If you had a big enough piece of paper, you could use one piece of paper. You wouldn't even have to do two. Or you could do multiple different papers. You could use to do three, or you could Mod Podge it with multiple papers. The options are endless. It would be an expression of yourself. That's what I'm actually going with this planner. I'm kind of making this an expression of myself. And there is the base for my planner. I'm just going to cut this little bit off and throw that over to the garbage and put my washi back to the side here. So now I have the base for my plant. Now I'm going to show you my first Unity stamp, which is my Piper Girl. And again, I colored my Piper Girl with Spectrum Noir markers, and I didn't use too many on this one, so I can give you the rundown, but I will put them in the link below. I used CR9 for her sweater and shoes, and I used TB1, TB3 for her dress and shirt, and her hair, which I'll bring it in closer so you can all see. Her hair is purple, which I used PL4 and PL2. Anybody who knows me a little bit, I like to experiment with different colors, and I am a licensed cosmetologist in my state. My daughter has had and currently has purple hair, but she has had many different colors of hair, and I would love to have purple hair, but my daughter would never allow it. I like to experiment with different reds. I've had like a burgundy purple. That's about as close as I'm going to get to purple. But I couldn't resist giving this girl purple hair. And then I also used the Nicole Premier markers in peach and apricot for her skin, because I tend to color a little bit better with the Nicole markers for the skin tone. I haven't mastered doing the Spectrum markers for the skin tone, but I like how the Nicole ones color for me. She again was stamped with Memento Tuxedo Black Ink on Nina paper. And all of my sentiments were stamped with Memento Black on various papers from the Chamel True Stories and Amy Tan line, Rise and Shine. I'm going to take my Memento Black ink now, and I use a lot of makeup wedges, and I'm going to just lightly ink around the outside of my Piper Girl so that she matches the outside of my sentiments, because I inked around all the outside of them. So I'm going to lightly ink around the outside of her. And I'm going to decide where I want to place her on my planner. I think I kind of want her centered. I did play around with this ahead of time a little bit. And I believe I have mentioned before that when I play around making projects ahead of time, it's best to, like, if you can take a photo on a phone or something, it gives you an idea of where you have things laid out. And I had her kind of centered, and that also allows me to go back and pick out the sentiments that I knew that I wanted on my front cover. So I can go and pick them back out and pull them out and kind of lay them where I had them. And then I'll be able to read to you some of the sentiments that I chose. I wanted this planner to be sort of an inspiration for me, so that when I look at it, it tells me, hey, like this sentiment here, what is possible in art becomes thinkable in life. And the first one, create every day. When I pull out my calendar and see what's going on for the day, it'll say to me, hey, go create something today. And another sentiment that I put on the front here is, let what you love be what you do. I love creating. I love scrapbooking and stamping. I want to really reinforce that next year. I want to make sure that I try to do it every day. And of course, the sentiment, you make every new day beautiful. Every day should be beautiful, no matter what. When you wake up, you should just look at your new day as beautiful. Always believe something wonderful is about to happen. Love that sentiment. So I want this to be a positive affirmation for me for my new year. So that, to me, is about how I want my front cover to look. So now that I got them all laid out here, I think I'm going to again use my glue pen and grab them and start putting a little bit of glue on the back of each one. And we're going to just start attaching them and putting them down there. And I had so much fun creating with all of these Unity products this week. I love the Angie Girl stamps, but doing these projects this week, I came to realize how much I love my sentiment stamps and how much I really need to pull them out and use them more in my projects, especially my layouts. I did a few layouts for you this week during this week of Unity, and I just love how much more a sediment brings to a layout. Out of curiosity, is there something that everybody out there, is there something that you all love that you realize that you need to use more of? What is it? Tell me. Share with me. I'm curious. I would love to hear from everybody what their favorite things are and what they think they have that they realize that they should be using more of or they want to use more of. I love my Unity stamps, and I do use them frequently, but I didn't realize how much that I should be using my sentiments more than just on my cards. Let's place this little sentiment here. And I love, one other little trick that I did on this is I use different die cuts I used like a label that I cut here and a different shape here and just a rectangle and a rectangle just to give it a little different flair. Now we can't do, I don't want to do anything too two-dimensional. That's why I'm not, normally I would have foam dotted these up, but since it's just my planner and my planners usually get a lot of wear throughout the year because they're constantly in and out, marking things down that I have to do. I don't want to make it too two-dimensional. So, and that's the start. That's the front of my planner. Now I'm going to flip it over and we're going to work on the back. And for the back, I chose just a bunch of different sentiments from the collections. And I chose this sentiment, which says, strength doesn't come from what you can do. It comes from overcoming the things you once thought you couldn't. And I absolutely love that sentiment. That should be an everyday thing that you say to yourself from the moment you wake up. And this little one says, I'm not who I was yesterday. Then I have this one that says, don't be pushed by your problems, but led by your dreams. Absolutely stunning. This one says, inspiration exists, but it has to find you. Oh, I'm sorry. Inspiration exists, but it has to find you working. And that's from Picasso. Love it, love it, love it. Put it on there. And then just a simple two words, be strong. Put that one there. And this one, believe that you can and you will. These are real simple affirmations, just simple statements, but so empowering. And another one here, you never know how strong you are until being strong is the only choice you have. Just, they're just beautiful sentiments that I think when I pull my calendar out, if I'm having one of those days, I can just look at this and say, yes, read one of these and it will give me the inspiration I need, the strength I need, the perk up I might need for that day. And it's just beautiful to look at. So I think that's how I want to lay those out. A little bit of pink and the tealy colors and a little bit of the blue-gray and the white in there. And I'm going to go ahead and grab my handy-dandy glue pen. And we're just going to go ahead and we're going to glue those all down. The only thing about working with this glue pen, for me, I get a little sticky fingered. So, I just have to be careful not to get the tops too sticky. So, I have, of course, always nearby, some handy dandy baby wipes. So, I'm going to wipe off my fingers here real quick, because I don't want to smear up my planner. So we're going to just continue to keep sticking these down here real quick. And if anybody has any questions about anything that I have done in any of my Unity projects or any of my projects, feel free to ask. I have no problem answering them for you. Leave me a question, private message me. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. It may not be instantaneous because, as I said, I do have two teenagers that sometimes keep me busy. So it might take me a few to get back to you, but I promise I will get back to you. And one more to go, and we got all the sentiments. That one stuck more to my finger than it did to the book. Got a sticky finger there. I love the coffee cup paper because if anybody knows, I love coffee themed. I had thought about taking this in the route of coffee themed, but I just love the sentiments so much that I thought the empowering words and the positivity that I want to bring into my new year and the message of empowerment and being able to be positive and look at this and say, yes, I need to create today and make something beautiful today. Overtrumped my coffee theme, but I had to put that little bit of coffee cup in the background. So I'm gonna open this up so we can see a whole, that's what it looks like from back to front. And there's a view of the front and a view of the back, and could ink around the edges and stuff, but I kind of like it kind of plain. I think there's enough blackness going on with all the inking around the edges. But I do want to go in and take, I have these enamel hearts. These were from Michaels. They're the Recollections enamel hearts. I do want to go and take just a couple of these because they're a little dimensional, but not too much. I want to take just a couple of these since there's the little hearts in the Piper Girl. I just want to take a couple of these, and I think I want to take the red ones since I have the red striping here. I want to take these red glittery ones, and I just want to put a few of these. On the front here, just like so. And then, since this was a pre-bought calendar, I made sure that I bought one that had the plastic sleeve that came along with it, so it will protect my creativity. So I just need to slip it back inside of its protective cover. It should fit. It'll be a little bit snugger than what it was when it first came out because we added another layer onto it. But it should fit right back in there. And it doesn't want to go in there quite right for me. Okay, I got the front in. Okay. Now we want to take that back page. And we're going to want to put it back inside its plastic sleeve. Down and just smooth it out, and there you go. I have a very nice decorative calendar planner, and there's no saying that I can't go inside and decorate the inside up if I chose to. Myself personally, I probably won't, but you could. The sky's the limit. You could decorate the inside. But for myself, I chose to, I just wanted to decorate the outside. And using some very beautiful Unity products, it's stunning. Simple little project makes a beautiful work of art. A dollar calendar turned into a book of inspiration for me to hopefully inspire me every day of the upcoming year. And with that, I just want to share again the products that I used. I used Piper Girl and Donna Downey Studios Empowering Word. And again, I want to thank everybody at Unity. And please go to the Growing in Unity Facebook site. I will leave all the links down below. Leave a comment, get a chance to win some Unity goodies. And thanks everybody for sticking by me for my week as a Growing in Unity gal. I had so much fun, and I'll see you at my next video. Thanks, guys. Bye.